Hello beautiful people, how are you doing? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Cess Paulo and thank you for clicking on this video. And if you're new here, kindly consider subscribing to this amazing channel. As you can see today, guys, we are in my kitchen and I am wiping down my mini fridge because today I'm going to show you how I organize my mini fridge. As you can see, it is very tiny, but I managed to store almost all my food in here. And as you can see, this is the freezer section, which is very tiny, but this is where I store my meat, as you can see. And so first of all, before storing my meat, I make sure that I wrap it in aluminium foil, because you find some meat usually have some blood and it makes the cleaning to be easier if you wrap it in aluminium foil. And it's also going to prevent your fridge from having smells of meat. Izo maharufu za nyama, you will not get them when you wrap it like that. And then next, I am going to store my smokies, which are very convenient for breakfast, and I just squeeze them up on top of the meat. That's why I love putting my meat flat, so that it gives me extra storage. And then next, I am going to store my ice cream. So basically here, I just store things that need to stay frozen. And this ice cream, guys, has been on offer for quite a long time, almost a whole year. And you like buy one and you get one for free. And next, I am going to store my tomatoes because I cook a lot. So I need quite a lot of tomatoes, and I'm just going to store them in the vegetable section and one beetroot there. And then I am going to store my matoke, guys, because I love making soup made out of matoke and pumpkin. I did not get a nice pumpkin, but I love matoke too. So there we put my matokes too. And this is how the vegetable section looks like. As you can see, guys, I still have enough storage for me to come and put my pilipili hohos. So the next thing, I am going to store my cooked food. As you can see, there's some rice there and some spinach, and I store it in the middle section because that's one, like, a very cold section. That's why I love putting the food that I have already cooked there. And I have my black beans here and my red beans. As you can see, guys, I use rectangle tins to store my food because that allows me to store more food as compared to circular containers. So if you use rectangle containers, you are going to get more storage for your food. As you can see, I have stored already 4 pre-cooked meals. That is quite a lot of food for me. And then now here we are going to store our berries. And guys, I love strawberries a lot because they're very yummy. I can make smoothies with them. I can eat them as snacks. And also when you dip them in ice cream, they're very tasty. So I have quite a lot. And they also last very long because I discovered the longer they stay, the sweeter they get. They actually don't spoil. And that is where I store them. And for the bananas, I would have stored them in this tin, but the fridge is tiny. They cannot fit in the container, so I just store them like that. And they are ripe, but not too ripe. And I know, guys, like, bananas usually brown when you store them, but these ones are not going to stay for so long, like 2 to 3 days. So I don't mind storing them like that. And when you store them in a paper bag, they actually spoil faster, so I just prefer storing them there if they cannot fit in the vegetable section. For the broccoli, I usually wrap it in cling film, but I ran out, same as the yellow and the red capsicum. I usually wrap them, but when I discovered I didn't have the cling film, I was not going to run just so that I can come and film this video, but you can still store it like that. And then in this section is where I store my juices because the storage is just enough for the juices. And this go fruit, guys, also is very yummy, and it's only 98 bob and it tastes like real fruit. It's 98 or some places 100 bob. My tomato paste, I put it on the top part of the freezer of the door because I don't want to store some things there and then they end up becoming too cold. I also have some remainder of tomato sauce there, and my wine there. I love wine, guys. And also my water there. Because sometimes I want very cold water, so they are my mustard. And then I come in the spaces that are left on the sides. That is where I stack my milk, guys. And as you can see, my fruits are in a container. So even if it's fresh milk, of course, I would put it on the door. But even if you put it here, it's not going to smell because all the other things are wrapped apart from the vegetables. And there I can fit so many milks. If I have extra milk, I can put it on top of the strawberries. And the space on top of the strawberries is even enough for you to stack a pizza, a whole pizza there. As you can see, it's big enough. So I decided to put the maziwa mala behind the broccoli and then my choma sauce down there. I also put my tomato sauce down there, but I am out. Then that is bicarbonate of soda, which helps in absorbing bad smells from the fridge. So that is how the vegetable section looks like right now. And that is the bottom, my bicarbonate of soda, very important. It's very affordable and it saves your fridge a lot of smell. Then that's if you want extra storage, you can put the veggies up there and you have extra storage on the sides. Like, I still have a lot of storage if I need to add more food. A whole half a cabbage can fit there. This fridge is very tiny, but as you have seen, it can accommodate quite a lot of food if you organize it well. If you don't organize your things, guys, this fridge will not fit even half of the things I've put here. And as you can see, we still have so much storage. And I also believe when you're arranging your things, you should try to make them look beautiful because you also want to feel the beauty when you open the fridge. It's supposed to add to the aesthetics of the kitchen. Don't just come and stack your things. No, this is where I put my cooked food. No, this is where I put my fruit. So even if you come with extra fruits and you're in a hurry, you know this is the section where I'm going to put the fruits. And so it's just going to look nice, beautiful, presentable, and you can also see almost everything that you need. You don't need to keep searching for things, because if you have to keep searching for things, it means your fridge is not organized. And that is how the fridge looks when I turn it on. And it's recommended, guys, that you put your fridge up to three quarter full. You don't make it so full and not so empty, because so full and so empty is going to lead to more energy consumption. But around three quarter, you have enough, just enough space for air circulation. And if you don't have enough things, guys, it's better that you just stack up bottles, empty bottles, and just no bottles of water, and just put them inside to save energy. And that is how tiny the fridge is, guys. Look at that. It's that tiny, but holds so much inside. It is very beautiful, as you can see, and I love it so much. And if you love it too, guys, give it a big thumbs up, turn on the notification bell, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.